Hello everybody, Helen the Russian here. Welcome to my channel. Today's topic, unfortunately, is really very sad. It is regarding the shooting that took place in New Zealand yesterday. Some of you may know, I mentioned that before, I hold three citizenships. One of them is New Zealand. I have a lot of friends in there. I lived there for 10 years. Thankfully, by the grace of God, none of my personal friends got hurt or affected by what had happened, but 49 people are dead and 20 are injured. This, another senseless act of violence, I don't need to say that. Couple of things. First of all, according to the police report, the person who done it is actually Australian national, which is of significance because of apparently he issued a manifesto. He had problem with migrants. Well, he was a migrant in New Zealand. Let's make it very clear. It wasn't his country to even decide on this or that. The way things work between New Zealand and Australia, they have reciprocity for their citizens, meaning if one holds an Australian citizenship, one can go into New Zealand and have and legally live and work in there without need for any additional visa. And same for New Zealanders who go to Australia, which is why I'm really happy to have New Zealand citizenship, because it allows me to live and work in Australia legally without any additional visas. There were some issues in the past where Australia reduced the privileges, meaning the Kiwis, which in New Zealand, that's what New Zealanders call themselves, Kiwis can go or live and work in Australia, but they're not eligible for any benefits of Australia, none whatsoever, while Australian citizens, when they go to New Zealand, they are eligible for everything. So there were some tensions regarding that, and then Australia been known to deport few Kiwis who lived there most of their lives, but they were career criminals, so they literally just send them back to New Zealand, and there was a bit of an issue there. Well, now obviously the other shoe dropped, and I'm sure there will be discussion on the subject. Also of note is the fact that New Zealand police, I'm here to tell you, they're not asleep at the wheel. New Zealand police are very much onto it. A lot of it has to do with the fact that New Zealand is not a large country. Total population is just over 4 million for the entire country. To give you an idea, population of Las Vegas currently is just over 2.1 million. So twice the population of Las Vegas is the entire country of New Zealand. And New Zealand is comprised of two islands, North Island and South Island, and Christchurch is in South Island. And Christchurch, unlike, say, Auckland, which is in North Island, Christchurch is not as sparsely populated, especially after the major earthquake that they had a few years back. And generally speaking, I've lived there for 10 years, and I have a good idea of how New Zealand police operates. They usually are well aware of most of the happenings and goings. Mainly has to do with the fact, like I said, a lot of towns and even cities like Christchurch not densely populated, and so police gets a lot of information and they keep a watchful eye on everyone. And while I was in New Zealand, there were a couple of major operations, sting operations, and they both had to do with drugs. But what I'm trying to say, like, say for instance, it's a house in a neighborhood out of which drugs are sold regularly. It's not because police doesn't know or lets them get away with it. It's because there probably is a large investigation to bust the entire ring of drug dealers, not just that particular one, which is why they're waiting to do it. And I've seen that happen a couple of times. Some of those operations take up to 2 years. And police is also New Zealand, because it is such a small country, and they reasonably recently, I'm not saying in the last few years, but I think it's only last three or four that they started having driver's licenses with the photos. They didn't used to have driver's licenses with people's photos on them. It was just a piece of paper. But what I'm getting at, in New Zealand, all government computer systems are connected to each other. And because, for instance, health system, and they're subsidized by the government, when you go to the hospital for whatever reason, and they input your information in the computer, they have police have access to all of it straight away. And because New Zealand is an island, well, two islands, but you know, island, pretty far away from everywhere, in the middle of two oceans, actually, it is really hard to get away from there. To give you an example, there was a case in Auckland when one person was involved in a drunk driving incident where someone was injured, and in there, generally, police don't take them. They don't really have equivalent of what we have as CCDC here in Las Vegas. So they let them go with the provision that they have to turn up in court. So that particular incident happened at around 10 p.m. in the evening, really late. And that person tried to get on the plane to Australia next morning at 9 a.m. Well, he was already flagged on the computer, meaning that he couldn't leave the airport. When he tried, the red flag came up and police came and arrested him. So it is very surprising to me that these people, clearly there was some planning that went into the whole thing, and they clearly stayed under the radar. No one had any clue of what was happening, which is very obvious. And I can tell you, New Zealand police is very concerned at the moment. So I'm getting updates from U.S. consulate in New Zealand. As an American citizen living abroad, I'm registered with the consulate, and we all automatically get updates when things like that happen. And New Zealand police just raised the alert from low to high over the entire country. They saying that it is possible this was not limited just to Christchurch. There might be other incidents, so there is high alert all over New Zealand right now, which tells me police is very concerned at the moment. They don't do this lightly. In fact, I can't remember in my time in there that never happened, and I don't know when that happened last time. So they're trying to figure out who else might be involved, how it all came to be. Obviously, there's going to be a massive investigation, but at the moment, everyone in New Zealand is quite concerned, because here is the thing, that this person targeted Muslims. Obviously, he went to the mosques, but who is to say, they use the word migrants, and who is to say that next people they're going to target could be Chinese, Indians, Russians. Who knows? So police is obviously very concerned, but like I said, New Zealand police is very capable. I'm sure they're going to figure it out. And the small size of, well, relatively small size of the country, the fact that it's so isolated and all the computer systems are connected, will definitely help them in the investigation. I'm pretty sure we're going to know what all happened. Hopefully it was just this nutter and his three friends. I think there were three more people involved in it, at least what we know so far. Only one person was charged, I think, so far. But they'll figure it out. And once again, just a random nutter who was a migrant himself decided he's gonna protect his country, which wasn't even his country. He was guest, just like everybody else was in there, from migrants. Really very sad. Obviously my heart goes out to those affected and to the entire country of New Zealand generally. Not to say there is no violence in there whatsoever, that New Zealand has a serious gang problem, which is why again police keeping a watchful eye on the happenings in there. But it is not often at all that there are incidents involving firearms, and definitely the last mass killing in New Zealand was, I think, in 1990, to give you an idea, and that 13 people were killed then. But generally speaking, people are not armed. It's fairly hard to get a gun in New Zealand. You have to have a license, you have to have a permit, you have to undergo very rigorous background check, which includes home visit to see if you have a proper storage for your guns. It's not like it is in here, where you can go to sporting goods store and arm yourself to the teeth, once you undergone the background check, which takes about a week or so. Anyhow, my condolences to those affected, to their families, and my heart goes out to New Zealand. Kia kaha.